Hello. Now, Nick Cook, beer outlaw reviews, start the topic on the How did you get, or why did you get into beer as a small? Now, I did do a video for it, but I was on an ale trail at the time, and I was drunk, and I'm like, you can kind of guess how that went. It was a nice video. I liked it, but I didn't want it anyway. The second one, I did it for people that I'd started introducing Real Alter. I did that video. It was a good video. I enjoyed that. The third video, put a response. Did do it and it was nice, but the sound was bad. And basically, I was drunk as well, so a combination of bad sound, bad. So, I thought, do it again on my laptop at home, relaxed and calm. Anyway, on to the topic. How and why did you get into real ale? Now, I've only been drinking alcoholic beverages for like 10 years. Before then, I was more of a recluse. Ginger hair, you can kind of guess where I'm going. A recluse, I didn't really go out much and I didn't do anything. It was just a select few that made me break out my shell and try. Battle my shyness and Stuart Furlough, Ben Cunningham, Emma, Sam Chitty, Phil Butterfield, this list goes on, but Martin Hannon and all different ways helped Eric Timperley and Liam Fitzpatrick, all helped in their own little way. Now, when I first started drinking and socializing, it was just basically, you can guess, kind of guess what it is. I was 25 years old. Yes. I didn't start drinking until like 25. And because I've been drinking pop all my life, well, 25 years, went on to the alcohol pops, which is like Reef and I can't remember, Bacardi Breezers and stuff like that. Escalated, WKDs. And those kind of drinks, and then went on to, as always, it goes on to the next stage, which is lagers. Now, I was never a fan of all lagers. Some of them just didn't agree with me. Beck's beer was really nice, but Beck's was could not drink. Kronenbourg was okay in parts. Stella, I always enjoyed. No matter, I still enjoy it today. Carlsberg Expert, I enjoyed. Carlsberg was just too much like water. Same with Budweiser, too much like water. Coors was nice, but eventually it'd be too long. It just goes. Anyway, me and my brother Andrew, which you, I do some videos with. But it's because his birthday and my birthday seemed to around the same time. Basically, I'd go out my birthday and he'd pay the beers. And then we'd go out for his birthday and I'd pay for all his beers. And we started experimenting. Neither of us was into craft beer or real ale at that time. And it went on for like 2 years. And first we tried all the American beers and the Polish beers. And the German beers, all really nice beers. Apart from Brooklyn Lager, I could not like that at all. Didn't like that at all at first. I said to my brother, I says, this tastes like sweaty shoes. He agreed. Then we stayed clear of American beers because none of them were really good about that then. So, we moved on. We went on these national holiday trips and went to Germany and Belgium and all that stuff, and Scotland and Devon, and they're all good beers. It just seemed they're not really sticking. I'm like, I'm gonna go back onto drinking no beer at all. But then my mentor started taking me to these beer festivals. First beer festival I ever went to was the Bradford Beer Festival 2008. Now, I've said to myself, this is really a turning point, because if you're not going to like anything from the year, just turn back and just don't drink any more alcoholic beverages. I experimented over the years, from the first 2 to 3 years, I experimented spirits, alcohol pops, everything. I've drunk it all. I stayed clear of spirits after. I mean, me and Stuart said a little bit, so you used to go out drinking, or you could drink at Jumping Jacks. We've all been there. Or you could drink at Thursdays, I think it was. We started going to Bradford Beer Festival, and I selected beers that it was a webcam, so I selected beers that you would not normally see in any pub or anything else, and they were all like crazy beers. Some were really nice, some was terrible. But anyway, moving fast. The only beer I did like back then was Fixins All Peculiar. Fixins All Peculiar. We would drink it every Friday afternoon at Fanny's Ale House in Saltaire. It had the combination of different textures of dark as well as medium as well as... It was just really nice and tasty. And we drink pints and pints of this stuff. Apparently we didn't last long. This is like crazy beer. But yeah, that was the first real enjoyable ale. I've had many since then, obviously. 10 years. Many of us stuck up beers have, but for me, it's a combination of favourite beers from, I've had like Polish and Czech and German and Yorkshire, and all my favourite places for beers. Belgium's in there who was a comedy club, and the first Belgian beer I started to really enjoy was Chimay Red. We had Chimay Blue Fine Cock in Bradford, and me and my mentor Ben, we were like, why do we bother? We were like, we're almost out of our tree, and it was the first beer we had, first time we had it. But it is, because of different stages. But I've been talking for ages. That's so many beers. And over the 10 years, Yorkshire beers, I don't know what it is, they're more solid, because I don't know if it's the water or the way they brew, but Yorkshire beers are always the best. I've had American beers since then, obviously. But my first American beer that I really enjoyed was the Anchor Porter. Me and my mentor Ben, first beer festival outside Bradford, we'd gone to Ebden Bridge, the Fox and Goose. Really nice pub at the time. Beautiful beer garden. I still say that's the best beer garden in Yorkshire, simply because you go to the pub, and it's really old pub, and it's like all it sells is real ale. Get your beer, and you got this like really like it's like your own house, and you go upstairs, and you enter the beer garden, and it's got this old brickwork, and you sit in the garden, and all you can see is green trees. Granted, if you look down, you see a road, but it's on the road. But yeah, apart from fixing stuff queer, I had so many other beers since then. Other beers. Aberdale Absolution still stands as one of my favourite beers. Jennings Snecklifter, another. After 10 years of other so many beers. I mean, Yorkshire brews, so many different breweries and all stuff. Great Brewery, Brightstones Brewery, Saltaire. I've had so many memories. Me and Mentor and all the Friday clan from Fanny's Ale House used to trip down to Saltaire Brewery and the Friday Club. Ilkley Brewery. All their range is just. Can't go wrong with Ilkley Brewery. Yeah, my first single hop beer, I think it has to be Goose Eye Brewery, and it's their Chinook. But yeah, first real ale I really enjoyed and still do is Dixon's Old Pure. I do enjoy Wychwood Hobgoblin. I mean, now it's just a solid beer. And if I see it in a pub, I'll definitely get it. If it's not else on, because I still try to get try new breweries and all that stuff. There's just so many out there. What else is there? But yeah, I mean, one of the reasons I continue to drink real ale or the lagers. It's because there's so much flavour out there, and I still try even his second beer chat, Nick Beer Hour, said, beer snobber. Now, I do see it. I do see it on the internet, on the social networks, as well as in the pubs and the beer festivals and such. I do see it. The thing about it is it is a like plus and minus thing. I mean, the good thing is when I do it, my beer snobbery is basically what I do is tell them why I drink it and the reasons. And recently, people do listen to what I'm saying, and there's tried different ones. I mean, I've tried so many different beers. I'll kind of guess what they will enjoy and what they don't enjoy. But majority of the time, I'm on target for guessing the right beers. Liam Fitzpatrick, drinking beer and such for like 40 years. Got him a wheat beer. We've just basically gone for a long walk around Skipton, along the hillside and all that nonsense. Got back and he purchased me a beer and I purchased him a beer. Now he asked for his commercial lager. Now, because I know there's a difference, I gave him a Erdinger, I think it was at the time. It's a beautiful beer. He had it at first and he goes, oh, I don't like it. But then he gradually went, by the end of it, he was enjoying it. And he goes, maybe I should send you to bar more often. And that's what it's all about. It's just slowly educating people that drink commercial beer. I mean, there's so many different things to do and experience in this life. Don't be sat drinking commercial or even the same real ale. Keep trying all different ones. I mean, recently taking my friend Martin at work to all the beer festivals and ale trails, and he's been drinking commercial beer Carlsberg for such a long time. But he's recently started to enjoy German wheat beers and dark ales, which is good, because I do suggest when you're trying something, go for something very dark first, because it's the alternate of the balance. Jenny, stop the food. Sticky fingers. But yeah. I did see on some forums the other day, a bit of beer snobbery. Now, the thing about that is, just because you don't like it, doesn't mean it's bad beer. It just means that you don't like it. Simples. Now, a bad beer is something, when you open a bottle, or when you pour it from a cask, it doesn't taste normal. That's my opinion on a bad beer. Now, that's bad beer. Because you don't like it, that's not a bad beer. That's because you don't like it. And that's what kind of irks me sometimes. I'm with Martin, it's just, I'm to keep, when I get some extreme, I let him have a taste, so he knows what's there. But, yeah. People, get the facts right. Now, bad beer snobbery. First, where are they? Okay. Now, I can't believe I've been talking for like 18 minutes. Now, some more beers that I started getting into when Wells and Young Beers. Now, back in the day, me and mentor basically work at a distributor. I'm not going to say the name or thing, because then I get in trouble. I don't want to get in trouble, and now I need payment beer. And we'd used to get this, the Wells Bombardier Satanic Black. It was the best one they did. It was the dark beer version. And they stopped distributing it, and the Wells range started adding like alternate things to cut price. The problem is that when you start taking stuff away from a good beer, it stops being the same good beer. Now, take this. I'm eating frozen chicken. Well, not frozen, I've cooked it. But if I used proper chicken, proper spices and all stuff, and went to preparation of cooking it and all that stuff, it would be better for me. It would taste better, and it would probably be cheap as well. But because you're using all these different chemicals and all these different laws, and it's probably going to end up being worse for me. It's not going to be all natural like a real ale is. And it's another reason why I drink real ales. sweetness there. But yeah, I've had so many different kinds of beers. Natural, chemically added, and carbonated and all that stuff. I do like, even though I drink real ales, I will drink commercial beers as well. Because you can only give so much of a view before you and yourself don't know what you're talking about. I never know what I'm talking about anyway, but you know what I'm saying. Hey there. Anyway, oh, also, didn't it? Oh, you should all do it. In my opinion, if you know money, so I can drink it. You should only drink it home, I think, reckon. If you're tight on money, which is why I'm drinking now. Because I can't afford to go out and enjoy a real ale pub. Or even a pub. Because I'm saving for a burger. And I am on minimum wage. Now, concerning pubs. It's another situation. Now, it's a flip coin. Now, a pub does well if it gets multiple people coming in the pub, keeps the pub alive, which is our point. We have to keep going to these pubs so they stay good. You stop going to those pubs, start getting lazy, and the beer gets bad for really ill people or whoever walks into the pub randomly. I think it ends up with a bad name. Escalates to closing. Well, you don't want that closing. Because eventually when you're going to go back to the pub, it's not going to be too good, is it? Because there's no pub there anymore. And you're going to complain and all that stuff about all the pubs closing. Anyway, it's down to your fault. But on the flip coin, if the pubs don't pay attention to the beer, the people aren't going to come back. So, this is a win-lose thing. It's basically everybody's got to do their part. I mean, I love going to pubs. I love going, trying to, again, the social thing. My shyness. It's, when I'm in a pub, I just feel comfortable. It's like being at home, but you get proper beer instead of home. You get like, you're not guaranteed a good beer. Whereas even in the pub, you actually go to the pub and if you don't get it right the first time, they'll pour it through and then give you a good beer. Whereas if you're at home, if that's a bad beer, you don't get those second chances. But yeah, I love going to pubs, chat to all different kinds of strange people. Well, not strange, but strange, new people. I like chatting to different people, and the same with beer festivals. I've chatted to so many people when I'm at beer festivals, so many people at pubs. And it's like their enjoyment from drinking real ale or drinking different kinds of drinks. But yeah. Just try and do as much as you can before you, well, leave this life. But, yeah. Wow, I've been talking so long. I mean, for the instance, right, we've got a real ale. Yeah, 4.5%. it has this taste and enjoyment of a lager and an ale. So it's a perfect entrance. Keep trying it. I mean, they do offers at supermarkets, so you can like experiment at home. I suppose that's where drinking at home comes in handy. But only experiment at home for so long, because there's so many good real ale pubs and craft beer and pubs and all that stuff. And then you got this, which is a really nice beer. So you got your second stage. Now you've got your third stage, which is an higher ABV ale, darker, more intense, but you gradually, and then you go on to, this is where you experiment at home. Get some cheap, well not cheap, special offer real ales. Experiment a little, you know, try them. And then when you go to a pub and with your friends and such, you do try something different. But yeah, just get out of there. Try real ales. I mean, you can only drink so many, the same beer. I've drank so many beers and different styles. Zivets. It's a great Polish beer, and I'm lucky to get on tap over here in the UK. If you see that, really nice beer as well. Anyway, gotta go. Been talking so long. I'm hungry. Finish this food. Bye.